Welcome to an overview on the key features of the ERC Synergy Grant in Horizon Europe. My name is Ylva Huber. I am a member of the ERC team at FFG in Austria, and I hope this brief introduction to the Synergy Grant will be helpful for your further plan. With the Synergy Grant, the ERC supports small groups of minimum 2 and maximum 4 principal investigators or PIs and their teams. This is different from all other main ERC grants, which fund individual PIs and their teams. For a Synergy Grant, the expectation is that these innovative and active PIs will achieve something extraordinary by working together. They should combine skills, knowledge, experience, expertise, disciplines, methods, approaches, teams, access to infrastructures. It's a long list in the ERC work program, so that they can address ambitious research problems that would not be in reach for individual PIs or teams. As all other members of the ERC grant family, also the Synergy Grant is entirely bottom-up, thus it is open for any research topic. And this way, the Synergy Grant aims to fund transformative research. That means, according to the ERC, that it enables substantial advances at the frontiers of knowledge. These can stem, for example, from the cross-fertilization of scientific fields, from new productive lines of inquiry, or new methods and techniques. The Synergy Grant is open for unconventional approaches and investigations at the interface between established disciplines. And ultimately, research conducted by a Synergy group should have the potential for becoming a benchmark on a global level. The funding that the Synergy Grant offers is sizable. Up to 10 million euro can be granted per Synergy project for six years. In exceptional cases, additional funding of up to 4 million euro can be awarded. The PIs involved can be at any career stage, though so far, most PIs have applied at an advanced career level. And one of the up to 4 main host institutions engaging the PIs can be located outside of the EU or associated countries. And as always, additional team members can, if needed, be hosted at institutions outside the EU or associated countries as well. The sole criterion for funding a Synergy project is scientific excellence. And as is the case for the other main ERC grants, namely the starting, consolidator or advanced grant, this sole evaluation criterion will be assessed from two vantage points, the research proposal and the principal investigators. Now, this slide is supposed to be an overview on the main questions that ERC evaluators have to answer, though I am afraid that it is quite crammed with information already. For the detailed questions, please consult the ERC work program. It is the most important and legally binding document for ERC calls. The questions on the research project address its groundbreaking nature and potential impact, including the high gain, high risk nature, and they concern the scientific approach. Is it feasible and adequate? And does it go beyond what individual PIs could achieve alone? The cluster of questions on the PIs addresses the intellectual capacity and creativity of each of the PIs, but also the power, if you like, of the Synergy Grant group. Does it bring together the required know-how? Importantly, also these very synergy-related questions will already be assessed by the short version of the proposal you have to submit, the so-called extended synopsis. We will hear more about this in a minute, because this brings us to the key features of the Synergy proposal evaluation. Similar to the other ERC main grants, you have to submit two versions of your proposal in a single step. On one hand, a short 5 pages version of the proposal, this extended synopsis or part B1, which is accompanied by a 2 pages CV and a 2 pages track record for every PI. Simultaneously, you submit a second, more elaborated version of 15 pages. This is the research proposal or part B2 of 15 pages. While you submit these two parts at once to the single deadline of the call, the proposal will be assessed in 3 steps, not 2, like it is the case for the starting consolidator or advanced grants. And only if the first short part convinces the reviewers in step 1, they will read part 2 in step 2. And the third part is devoted to an interview with the panel members. If your proposal survives to the 3rd stage, the interview stage, there is a substantial chance that it gets funded. As Synergy projects may bring together different disciplines, though they don't have to, the ERC has fine-tuned the evaluation process for this scheme. Instead of the 27 evaluation panels, like it is the case for the other ERC main grants, there are only 5 evaluation panels operating for the Synergy grant, and they are roughly divided into the 3 scientific domains defined by the ERC. Typically, 2 panels have their center of gravity in physical sciences and engineering, 2 panels are more geared towards life sciences, and 1 panel focuses on social sciences and humanities. But these panels are dynamically formed, also with the help of IT tools. And furthermore, panel members may also move between different panels. And the aim is to arrive at the best possible composition of panel members for the proposal submitted to a particular call. Coming back to the evaluation steps. In step 1, only the short version, B1, is accessible to the evaluators, and these are the so-called ERC panel members. The long version remains encrypted in the online submission tool. Importantly, these ERC panel members will often not be specialists in the research area or areas of your joint project. They are also officially referred to as generalists. And typically, 3 panel members will read the short proposal individually in step 1. At this stage, the 5 panels have not yet been formed. Rather, there is one big panel composed by around 85 Synergy panel members and also, if needed, members from other ERC evaluation panels like the starting or consolidator or advanced grant. And at the end of step 1, the panel chairs and vice chairs within this large group select the proposals that will go further to step 2. In step 2, the 5 panels with approximately 15 to 18 panel members each are formed. And the generalist panel members will now typically be supported by several specialists. These specialists are additional remote referees, usually minimum 3, but can be much more, that the panel members have invited based on the synopsis. And they expect that these reviewers will bring in the required in-depth expertise to scrutinize the full proposal. The remote referees will send the individual evaluation comments to the panel members, but they will not participate in the discussion of the panel. Please note that in step 2, the full proposal, part B1 and B2, is evaluated by the panel members and the remote referees. And at the end of step 2, the panel members decide, based on their own assessments and taking into account the comments by the specialists, which proposals are so promising that they should go further to step three. In step three, all the remaining synergy groups are invited to an interview with the panel members in Brussels, or more likely these times online. And the panels may actually reshuffle again a bit to have the best possible composition of expertise. Due to its specific needs, features, and the additional step, the synergy evaluation process is quite resource intensive and takes a bit more time. As an example, you can see here the expected time frame for the evaluation of the Synergy Grant Call 2022, from the deadline on November 10th, 2021, to the expected notification on the final results, nearly 1 year will probably pass. To support the preparation of a competitive synergy grant proposal, we recommend to make use of a valuable resource offered by the ERC, namely its projects database. Meanwhile, you can find the abstracts of more than 120 successful synergy proposals there, along with the names of the PIs forming the synergy groups. Finally, we would like to invite you to contact the ERC team at FFG for questions on the synergy grant, and in particular if you're interested in our proposal check service. Thank you very much for your attention.